The photographers were out in force at Madame Tussauds, and Hill's Angels drove them to even greater efforts than usual. But they were really there to see one of Benny Hill's best-loved characters, Fred Scuttle. The dozy doorman took his place today alongside the Wogans and the JRs. The comedian still doesn't know the secret of Fred's success.
I don't know, but I can just tell you he is. I get letters sometimes. I had one the other day from, somewhere in America, from a police chief that said his policemen, when they're on the beat at night, if there's no one around, they greet each other with the Scuttle salute, which is...
The Benny Hill show's been seen in more than 70 countries throughout the world. Yet, surprisingly, it's the first time the comic starred at Madame Tussauds.
I hate it. I really do. I really hate it. No, don't. Oh.
100 close friends and family gathered at the church to say goodbye to the King of Comedy. Benny Hill was an intensely private man whose persona changed in front of a television camera. His character brought happiness to millions of people around the world. The heavy rain echoed the tears and emotions of mourners as a 67-year-old bachelor was laid to rest near his parents in a family plot at Hollybrook Cemetery in Southampton. Amid the many wreaths and flowers on the grass lay a huge bouquet from his close friend Phoebe. The card read, "To Teddy Bear, I love you very much." Former colleagues paid tribute to the star's greatness.
One remembers a very delightful companion. He was terribly pleasant to be with, very amusing. He never took anything terribly seriously, but that's one way of looking at it. The other way of looking at it is he saw through pretension very easily, and consequently he saw the funny side of everything.
Earlier, the vicar who held a private service in the cemetery chapel praised Benny Hill's natural instinct for entertainment and noted the criticism his saucy sketches attracted. But to fans who lined the roads to the cemetery, Benny Hill will always be the world's greatest entertainer. Deborah Bain for Thames News.